Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in this series, Advanced Introduction to, Advanced Development in Grasshopper, where in this video, I'm going to teach you how to add icons to your components and to your plugin. Because if you have noticed, the component that we developed before, the one that adds two numbers, it just gets this like empty box or like empty transparent pattern, Photoshop pattern, if you will. And if we go to the plugin itself, it also has like no icons. And that's kind of sad because as soon as we start adding more icons, all of them are going to have this empty icon, which is not nice. And what it is nice is to have a full plugin that has icons. And because if we're working in such a graphics heavy environment, icons are really good for memory. I think so. I'm actually a big icons person. That's why I always have them like this on my screen. But on top of that, when you have a lot of plugins in your Grasshopper, you can have them in two ways. You can have plugins that have the name as a tiny tab, but you can also right click on Grasshopper and say display them as icons. And if you display them as icons, you get this nice icon representing them, which is very nice because as soon as you start adding more and more plugins, keeping them by name is just, there's not enough room. So adding some kind of tiny icon like a joystick or like two grasshoppers or a pufferfish or whatever is also really nice for visual effect. So I'm going to teach you in this video how to add both things, how to add individual icons to each one of your components, but also how to override this default text, this default letter, and add your own icon to the icon tab. So what I've done is offline, I went ahead and I went to Photoshop and I unbrushed my graphic design skills and I made myself two icons. One is going to be PC, which stands for Parametric Camp, which is the name that I'm, fantastic name that I'm giving this plugin. And then the other one is just this simple plus symbol, which is going to be the one that I'm going to implement in the component that adds two numbers together. Now, you don't have to use Photoshop. There's a free open source alternatives such as GIMP or many others. So for really simple image manipulation like this, you can get, and you can use online tools, etc., etc. Now, what's important is that when you design your icons, the way Grasshopper uses them is that you need to make sure that the icons are 24 by 24 pixels. That's as of this recording, that is the standard size of Grasshopper icons. I believe that for Grasshopper 2, that will change and there will be a better resolution available for that. And so that's one thing. And the other thing is that it is convenient to save these icons as PNG files with transparency, because what Grasshopper will do is that it will use the transparency to overlay that icon properly and make sure that the things that should be in the back are transparent as well. So what I've done is I have saved these two icons. Now on my desktop, you can see that you can see them because it's black over black because of the transparency. But if I highlight them, you can see their shapes. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to bring in those icons into our Grasshopper plugin. So the way we're going to do this is the following. So we have our Grasshopper plugin component, our Grasshopper plugin, all right? And then the plugin is a full project that has assemblies, dependency, packages, etc. One thing that we're going to do is we're going to right click here and go to properties. And you can see that on the left hand side, you have a lot of things that define how this project is compiled and it's and has like a C# life of sorts. All the way at the bottom here, there is a tab called resources that we can touch so that our project knows that it needs to keep track of certain files, static files that will be available to the code that lives inside of our project. So resources are basically that. Resources are files, either text files, bitmaps, or any other thing that you make part of the DLL that you compile and then you distribute with your code. And now you can see that we have a folder here called properties, resources, etc. Something that I can do is I can go, for example, here to change I can change the type of resource that I want to add. For example, I can make it images. And then what I can do is I can dock this all the way here to the right and then take my two images and drop them, drag and drop them here into the plugin. Okay. What that will do, I believe, is that it will create on your project, it will create this new folder called resources, and then it will automatically copy those two PNG files into the resource folder. That means that now the project contains those two files and that we can use them and manipulate them. One thing that I would like to do as well is let me figure out where the properties are. Here, properties. So here under properties, if I want to take a look at this, okay, so we can see now that the files are here in PC, plus sign, etc., etc. They are found here. This is the file name. And I believe, I'm not entirely sure about this, I believe that you may have to choose here copy always for the images so that the images are transferred to the DLL file. They're not loaded dynamically from the system. Okay. So that's one thing. We added the resource files to our C# project. I'm a little rusted with resources, so I hope that I didn't say anything that was utterly wrong. And then the next thing that we need to do is just for each component, we need to make sure that we attach to the component the right icon. So how does that work? Well, the way that works is that I'm going to scroll down all the way down to the override that is called icon. And in this override, what we can do is, if you look at, for example, the template that came with Grasshopper, you can see that here, and for the icon, right now it's returning null, but this override, what it does is it gives us a way to define what is the icon that the Grasshopper component should take in order to display it on its face. And as you can see from this explanation, it has to be a 24 by 24 pixel image, and we pick it up from resources. So how are we going to do that? So what I'm going to do is I can just write here properties and then find the resources namespace. And then here you can see that now magically almost, I have these two names, PC, which is parametric cam, that's the two letters, and the plus sign as a resource, all right? And you can see that they're already formatted as bitmaps, which is very nice. So we can do that, and then we can just save this, and this will work. Or we can do the shorthand getter form for all of this, which is basically removing all of this, and just saying, whenever you request the icon, just take this icon here and using what's called the arrow notation, which in C# means a pure getter. It's a function that always returns the object that we set here. Okay. So I'm going to close right now and I'm going to see if this works. So I'm going to close everything. I'm going to start the plugin. And because of how we linked things together before, we should now have this, and then I can open Grasshopper. And then, ta-da, oh, Grasshopper open on my other window. And then if I go here, you can see that, what? It has this really bad icon, really poorly designed, but it does have an icon. Okay. So now I can add two numbers with this ridiculous icon on the center. Okay, beautiful. So you could now, and we may actually do for all the components that we develop for the plugin, we may actually do icons for them. Okay. Now, what about the icon for the plugin itself, for the full plugin? How would we do that? The way we're going to do this is that we're going to follow David Rutten's advice on how to create icons for and other properties associated to a particular plugin. What he's recommending in this answer, which will probably be posted as a link somewhere in a card or will be here on the description of this video, is that basically there is this Grasshopper assembly priority class that we need to inherit from and create a class that calls the add category short name, symbol name, and category icon properties from a server object that we can load in that library in that class. And the way that works is that because David Rotten says that any class that inherits from assembly priority will be loaded before anything else in a plugin. So that sounds a little weird, perhaps. So let me show you how that would work out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new class, all right? But this one is not going to inherit from Grasshopper component. It's going to inherit from Grasshopper assembly priority, okay? Then where am I going to do that? Well, I'm going to start being a bit more careful about the distribution of my files. So I'm actually going to right click here and I'm going to add a new folder. And in that folder, I'm going to call it, for example, I'm going to rename it to, I can't rename it because I'm still running Rhino. Sorry. So I'm going to stop Rhino here. And then I'm going to rename this to utils or utilities or whatever. And inside of this, I'm going to add a new item, which is going to be a simple class. Okay. This one doesn't have to be a Grasshopper class. Doesn't have to be an empty Grasshopper because I don't want all the overhead and all the examples. I just want a simple one. Okay. And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say, this is going to be a public class. All right. I'm going to call this class, for example, tab properties. Okay. And I could call this plugin properties, I guess, too. Anyway, it doesn't matter. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that I am subclassing from Grasshopper assembly priority, which right now, as you can see, is giving me an error because I have not loaded in this class any dependencies from Grasshopper. So I probably need to say using Rhino and then using Rhino.geometry. I'm not going to use any of this here. I'm going to say using, for example, Grasshopper, using Grasshopper kernel, for example, right? And yes, and it turned out that this was found inside of Grasshopper kernel. You see how this one highlighted a little stronger? In general, when you're working with plugins, it's just fine to just copy paste all of this because the compiler will get rid of those who are not needed. So you can just add as many as you want here as well. And I'm going to rename this file to tab properties just because I like files to have the exact same name. Oops. Did I remove? Yeah, I did. I forgot. I removed the extension. So it has to be tabproperties.cs. Okay. So we have this. Okay. And what we need to do here is that you can see that tab properties is not implementing this inherited abstract member called assembly priority load, whatever. What that means is that because I'm inheriting from this class, what it means is that my class needs to implement at least this function that is part of the abstract definition of assembly priority. So I'm going to basically implement this function, and it already gives me a template for the override that I need to do. And then inside of this function, what I need to do is I need to do all that stuff that David was suggesting in his post. So first of all, I need to get an instance of a component server. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to define a server that is going to be Grasshopper server, no? Component server, exactly. So that's going to be one thing. And then on that server is going to be the object that contains the add category, the add icon, etc., etc. Think of this server object as similar to that P manager that we used to add interface with the inputs, interface with the outputs, etc., etc. So here I can say server dot and add category short name, for example, and that's going to be pcamp, and that's going to be, for example, PC. All right, that's going to be one thing. The other thing can be server dot add symbol name, and I'm not sure exactly what the differences are, But I'm just going to add the same thing here, just in case. Okay, we can probably read through the documentation. Or maybe the symbol name is just, maybe I need a character here. So that's what I'm going to do, P. And then for the icon, I say add category icon. And then it's asking me for a full category name. So that's going to be PCamp, for example. And then to add an icon. The add the icon is going to be under properties.resources.pc. Okay, beautiful. And then once I'm done with this, what I need to do is I need to return a loading instruction saying that everything went well, you can keep loading the plugin. Okay. Now, one thing that I want to highlight is that the category for the short name, I think this PCamp should probably be the same name as the name of the categories that we are defining here. So I think this, I'm not sure what I'm saying right now, but I believe this PCamp name, the one that we use for the categories, must be the same as the one that we say here. In case our plugin is defining different tabs or different categories, or we are adding components in different places, we can override or we can add different short names or different symbols for different tabs, okay? So I'm going to save this, I'm going to run this, and let's see if that works. Okay, and I'm going to trigger Grasshopper. And Grasshopper is opening here, and ta-da! Look how awful this looks. It looks terrible, but at least we have PC now. We have the tiny icon that I designed, and we still have the component with the icon, etc., etc. So we are ready, and we can use color here. I'm using black, but we can use color for this. We can use color for this. There's no reason. I should have probably used the parametric camp red, right? Can I do that? Let me do that for a second. I'm going to do that offline. All right, I just changed the color of the two icons and then I save them as PNGs. You can see them on my desktop. And then the only thing I need to do is I need to copy them and I go to resources where they are black and over transparent. I'm just going to replace these two files that will load them with its changes on my Grasshopper, on my plugin project. And then I can just fire this, open it up, and then the changes should now be updated, correct? Correct, correct, correct. And where is this? Yes, parametric camp in red here and the red operator. Now it looks like the red cross, but you get the point, okay? Beautiful. Well, this was icons and you can see that it's very easy to do. You just have to know exactly how to add the resource to the project and how to link that to the overrides for the component. And this is a special thing that we need to do for the icon here on that. Okay. But that's pretty much about it. Well, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, maybe subscribe to the channel or hit the like button, etc., etc. And let's move on to learning a few additional things, or perhaps it's time to get our hands dirty and do some practice exercises. We'll see what we do in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye.